Bindi Part 2. Rockmelon with dinner. We always have rockmelon with dinner. It's a mum classic. With dad in mind, I say. He hasn't got the teeth for harder fruits. I think us kids got his share. We got his hair too, and his height, and green eyes. Our golden skin is mum's. A hand-me-down reminder that we've been loved by grandfather's son and our ancestors for all time. I look more like mum than Omeo and Elsie. Her nose looks just like my nose. Which, over rockmelon, my Omeo pokes, just to check if it's squishy. And it is. Which causes Elsie to almost choke. And we all laugh in the belly of our home, where we are known and held. And all is well, while rockmelon is served at dinner. 2.2. At school, on a cloudy Tuesday, Auntie Lindy sits our class in a circle by the lake. Facing inwards, she talks about respect. In a space like this, about the timelessness of our meeting and the importance of caring for the country that you sit on and the country you belong to. Auntie Lindy explains, listening deeply means hearing from the heart, hearing with more than ears. She tells us of Garol, a Bajan, with symbolic colours, black, red and yellow. Her Duwi, sacred to our nation, a totem Bajan, one that sings in the Karet and speaks of Kanbi. We pause to hear her calls from far away. Naora, Naora, Naora. Hands to Daori, we join Auntie planting she-oaks. We palm their seed pods, rough and symmetrical. She says that they will keep us safe and connects us to the old people. We drip water at the base of the trunks to be. We erect small sentries to protect the seedlings. I hope they will withstand the drought and welcome the Bajan and their Karet. Art Class 1. On Thursday afternoons, Mrs. T visits and we paint. She takes us through archives of artworks by award-winning artists. We copy their ways and make our own versions of famous works. We hear their stories and learn new skills that I'll take to my wall at home. I'm a strong painter, but I don't let it show. I don't want to stand out. And though Mrs. T knows, she won't make a fuss. She understands and compliments me quietly, slipping me extra tasks when I finish early. Today, Mrs. T told the class about a project where a selected group will paint a mural on the brick wall at school. And she picked me to be in charge. I hope I can be a leader. 5.2. Olive and I walk to school. Black shoes kicking rocks on the dry bush track around the low lake. Where she oaks we planted sway in hot wind. And thirsty turtles sun themselves on forgotten logs. Olive is my best friend. I've known her since I changed schools. We play hockey together and swim and adventure together. Olive loves the music. People aren't ready to. She plays guitar and is kind to everyone she meets. Our parents say, "You are old enough now to take yourselves to school and to watch your sisters," which I think makes us old enough to make our own decisions. And today, I've decided that I don't like maths. I've decided I want to paint or draw or make. I want to create and tell the stories that matter, like my old people. Like I do at home when I take my paintbrush for a walk on my bedroom wall. And Dad acts surprised or mad until he sees a mess of colour and stroke, at which point he tucks me under his arm, scuffs my hair and says, "Don't do this again." Mum smiles, knowing I will, knowing we will all do this again. Next time I decide to redecorate my room. Bedroom wall mural 1. When the black cockatoo disappears and the sky dries, I'll know we're done for. Thank you.